everybody, happy Valentine's Day. Thank you everyone for all your lovely comments on my last video. I really appreciate that. And it's made this Valentine's Day very special. Special that it doesn't feel like it always does on Valentine's Day. It feels like a breath of fresh air, really. Because I have friends and beautiful viewers such as yourself that really genuinely care about me, and I really appreciate that. And it makes this day even more special, more than getting gifts or anything like that. And in fact, I'm treating myself right now, eating some Skittles. I haven't had Skittles since elementary school, like it's been that long, and I just had a green one. I just had a green one, and it honestly tastes like pine salt. Go to Walmart or wherever, go to the 7-Eleven and get you a pack of Skittles and eat the green one. I'm telling you, it tastes like pine salt. I swear, I think they put pine salt in the green one. It tastes like pine salt. For those who have smelled pine salt, it tastes like pine salt. Oh, anyway, again, yeah. Thank you all for your lovely comments. I really appreciate them. I feel so happy today. The first time in ages that I felt happy on Valentine's Day. And some good Skittles. And I printed off a couple of questions from a couple of my viewers who were seeking some advice on love. So I figured I'd go ahead and answer that. One of the questions, the person told me what their problem was, you know. But one thing stuck out that I wanted to address. And the person said that, you know, I'm 14, 15 years old. But please, don't say I'm too young for love. Because it really makes me mad when people say that about teenagers. Well, I would have never said that, you know. I think at a certain age, even when you're a teenager, you do feel that spark, that love, that puppy love, as they call it. And I don't think you're too young for love. I don't think you're too young to feel it. You know, I think in that process of starting to like girls or starting to like guys, you're starting to learn what love is all about, you know. But you don't know what love is all about. That's the thing. I think that's what adults try to tell you when they say you're too young. They're not saying that you know nothing, that you don't know what you're talking about. They're just saying that you're too young to really know the full extent of love. And you can always feel very strongly for a person, even at that young of an age of 14 or 15 years old. I mean, I felt that way. I thought I had the best boyfriend in the world, and it didn't last long. But I thought I did, you know? And it's common to make judgmental mistakes like that. In fact, you're supposed to make judgments like that, to thinking that, you know, you're this in love at a young age like that, because how else are you supposed to learn, you know? And with each heartbreak that you go through, with each relationship that you go through, you grow wiser, you know, so that the next time you go through these stuff again, you know how to better get through it, you know how to better take it and learn from your last mistake, take that and learn and come up with a better solution to get through this new mistake. So I don't think you're ever too young for love. I think you're too young to get deep as far as, you know, marriage is concerned, or thinking that you can be with this person forever. I think you're too young to know that for sure. I mean, you can't know that within the first 2 months of dating. You know what I mean? You only know that when you spent time with this person and you've kind of known and recognized their mannerisms and the way they behave and their personality and going through fights. You know, you're not really in love if you go through a fight and you break up after every fight. That's not a relationship. You can't break up every single time, because if you're going to do it that time, then you're going to do it during marriage. And it's ridiculous how high divorce rates are, because people don't know how to argue and then sit down and work it out. You know, no relationship can be perfect. There's no such thing as a perfect relationship. It's just impossible. You know, you're going to have your bad days and your good days. And how you get through your bad days determines how your good days is going to be. And if you can get through your bad days, then your good days will come at a breeze. You see what I'm saying? You have more good days than bad. That's just how it works. So, I would have never said that you were too young. I would just say, before you can determine that this is the person that you want to be with forever, be with them longer than a year, or two, or three, or four. A good 4 years is how you know that that person is good for you. And God, these Skittles are so good. I'm sorry, y'all. This is just... these are some good Skittles. Let's see. So, I hope that helped you out to the person who sent that to me. You know who you are. And just try to keep a positive outlook when adults tell you that. Adults only tell you that because they've only been down through there. They wouldn't tell you anything like that to insult you or to hurt you. They're only telling you that because they know what it's like. They're older than you, okay? They know what it's like to be in relationships. And they only tell you that because they've reached a point in their life where they know the meaning of it. They know what goes into a relationship. That's the only reason why they tell you that. So don't hold it against adults when they tell you that. They're only trying to help you out and looking for your best interest. Okay, it took me a long time to realize that, but it's true. It's really true. A light bulb comes on when you are 20 years old. And then 2 light bulbs comes on when you turn 30. And then 5 light bulbs come on when you turn 40. And then at 50, it's like, you know what? I don't have time for no mess. Okay? So, take heed to what your adults say. Take heed. The second question, well, story that I got was from a young girl who's also 14. You know, these are coming from young. Y'all are young. Sending me this stuff. What y'all talking about? She's 14, and she's a freshman in high school, and from what she told me, basically, I'm just going to paraphrase it, basically, if I keep looking down, it's because I'm looking at the time here, she was saying that she likes this young boy, but he has a girlfriend, and when she's at her locker, and he's the guy is with his girlfriend, and his girlfriend's lockers happens to be a few lockers down from her. He's always looking at her, smiling and stuff while he's at his girlfriend's locker. And that raised a red flag to me. If he's willing to do that while he's dating someone, then he's going to do that with you. And that kind of kid is just not worth talking to. She also stated that when she decided to do her hair and cut her hair and try a new style, you know, that he stopped paying attention to her. Now, if he's going to do that, then I guess looks is what attracts him, not personality. And if he's not willing to get to know you as a person, despite whether you walk to school in a dress, in an old woman's dress, if he's not willing to look past that and know you from the inside, then he's not worth talking to. He's just some boy. Okay? He's just some boy. Go on to the next train. Okay? In the words of Eddie from Family Matters, baby, that old train is left and a shiny new one is coming in. Okay? So give that shiny new train a chance to roll in on you and stop one that's worthy of a ride. You see what I'm saying? And you're not too young. You're 14. And you're starting to see now. Man, I need some skills. Good. You're starting to see now that young boy around your age, it's common for them to behave that way. And don't get mad at them. You know, as immature as it seems, don't get mad at them. They're supposed to act like that. It's very rare that you find a young boy at that age who behaves better than his peers, you know. I was privileged to meet about a couple of guys like that. I was older than them, but they just didn't behave like their peers. And, you know, when you find them, cherish them, hold on to them, you know. That means that you can learn a lot from them. They're like me, you know. When I was a kid, instead of hanging out with my cousins, you know, I always wanted to be around my aunts and uncles and hearing them talk about the gossip of the town. You know, why Miss James is kicking her husband out of a house because he's not going to work on time. You know, that kind of stuff. That interests me. I think that's why I have a lot of adults as best friends, as good friends, because I don't know. I guess I relate better to adults. I don't know. But I do have my young folks and younger who I relate to better, and I can always teach and lend a helping ear, you know. But I think that's why I've always been considered being more mature than my peers, you know. And I look funny in this video. Oh, well, anyway. So I think that's why. You know, I'm going to cut my hair, everybody. I'm going to actually cut this off. I'm not going to go real short. I'm just going to get it layered and try something different. I've always got my hair done and go long and It just needs to be changed. But anyway, just wanted to pass that along. But I've run out of time, and I want to appreciate all of you who send this stuff, and I appreciate everything that you all have been saying and sending this in and trusting me to help you out. I hope I did help you out. I've been babbling while eating Skittles, but I hope I did help you all out. So with that, I'm going to end the video. I will see you all later, well, tomorrow, but I hope everyone has a happy Valentine's Day, and keep it sweet. Don't spend too much money, and you all take care, okay? I'm going to go watch my court shows now. I'm missing Judge Alex, so I'll see you all later. Bye!